Hi Aries, welcome back to Omkara Tarot, and let's do your love bite now. A small little message for you to see what your love life is all about. I'm sorry I was missing last week, but I needed a much needed break. I'd gone up to the Himalayas to a beautiful hill station there called Shimla. And I'm back, and we start off with a bang, with a love bite. And then I'll do your other reading soon. I'll try and make up for last week, don't worry. And these are general collective readings, Aries, will not resonate with all of you. Take what works for you, okay? Leave the rest. My angel spirit guides, please bless this reading for Aries and send them the messages they need to hear the most right now. Thank you. So Aries, you know the love bites, right? Small little mini read to see what your energies are all about and what message needs to show through. Okay. And if any of you are looking for a private reading, Aries, my email is in the description box below. You can reach me there. All right. So something kind of ended, it seems, with a love partner, Aries. Both feeling down and out, feeling this is the end. But from what I see here, general overview, of course, I'm going to clarify all these cards. Somebody was kind of selfish or not taking action towards somebody who they knew was beautiful, loving, kind, and it didn't work out. I think all trust was lost in their partner, and because of the clarity gained about the selfish behavior, there is silence now. Neither of you are really talking to each other, both trying to get over your heartbreak and pain or whatever. But I do see somebody really restless here because they know now, because of their behavior, their partner is very, very angry and upset, but they're not willing to let go, Aries. That's the last card, death in reverse. So even though the feeling is there, or feeling betrayed, feeling all is lost, I think somebody still wants to come forward with some kind of an apology, but fearing it big time, because I think this Queen of Cups has now become the Queen of Swords. So, but not willing to let it go. Okay, of course we'll clarify all these cards. Let's start with some dialogue message cards, Aries, and see what's going on here. So Aries and their person, spirit, what do you have for them? If they could say something to each other. See, Aries, center of my spread, I have the High Priestess. So I would say the underlying energy of this reading is two people who are not talking to each other. Right? So this could be somebody from your past who was not very good in this relationship, who never offered stability, was selfish, and didn't value their person. Okay, one more. That's it. And I'm going to take a few of these as well. Messages from the heart. Okay. All set and ready to go, Aries. So the first card I have here says, nothing is more terrifying and simultaneously delightful than having to bear witness of how our two distinctive souls are joined in energetically for eternity. I understand if you're feeling scared, because it scares the F out of me too. So energetically, I don't think you guys have yet detached to that level where I know a lot of Aries are saying new love, new love, new love. So this is still pulling, and I think this person who was selfish in this dynamic has now realized it, and they are not wanting to let go. Death in reverse, see, they're not willing to let go of this connection. So I think they've kind of picked up on this energetic pull now. Maybe earlier they didn't feel it, and maybe that was one partner feeling it and wanting to bring this relationship together. But ever since, I think this Queen of Cups has, the person who was loving, kind, don't go by the pictures, it's not gender-based, okay? So whoever was the loving, kind person in the past, ever since they've turned their back, somebody is now kind of waking up. I realize I can't run from you because you are deep within me. See, that's exactly what I was trying to tell you. I realize I can't run from you because you're deep within me. We are one and eternally connected. when I run, I'm actually running from myself. When you've shown me in the mirror the reflection of what I don't like about myself and what I must heal. So maybe the person who was giving in the past probably showed them all their faults about how selfish they were, or how unstable they were, or how much of a liar or a cheat they were. And this person is now figuring themselves out. Maybe they didn't like being told in the past, but ever since the silence has happened, Aries, between the two of you, this person is taking stock of what they've done wrong. You have half our gifts, I the other. If you would only work with me instead of being silent and shutting me out, we could overcome any obstacles together and heal in sacred union. So this person is not happy with the silence, Aries. Now they're saying, hey, can we get back together? I'm very restless. I can't heal by myself. And they're not liking the fact that their partners become silent and upset with them now. Okay. I swear, you get more beautiful every day. With age, you refine and blossom like fine wine. You're absolutely stunning inside and out. I think ever since the silence has happened, this person is paying more and more attention to what they've lost. Though we cannot meet or see each other, still I love you more every day. My heart belongs to you for eternity. See how many references there are to this energetic soul contract or feeling each other energetically. Maybe one person is trying to detach now by being silent or pulling away their love now, but the other person is still attached. So that, hence this little stagnation, Aries, in your love life. I'm sorry, I know you guys are getting frustrated, but give it some time. Either this person is going to kind of wisen up, or the partner who has now detached or is trying to pull away is going to succeed, because you can't hold a person in that energetic field also forever. It'll slowly die down. So be good to yourself. I love you not only for your beauty, but also for your soul. Our love will be alive forever because of the way you are. Pure, true, authentic, real, raw, and passionate. So somebody is really kind of now understanding how wonderful their partner was and what their selfish behavior has done to kind of break this connection. There is a huge void in my life since you've been gone. Isn't that what we've been talking about, Aries? This person is now feeling empty. All the games they played, they managed to push their partner out, but now they're realizing, oh my God, this was such a vital part of my life and I don't feel complete anymore. We see this from two different perspectives. I don't know what that's pertaining. Maybe you guys are now not on the same page. One partner says, hey, I don't take selfish people in my life. The other person says, I was not being selfish. I was stupid, or whatever. I don't know. Last card here says, Aries, I really need your warmth and your affection. Because that void has come now. There is no love being given to the past, right? So let's put these cards here, Aries, and I'm going to start clarifying these cards. But before that, I'm going to take an angel blessing card to bless this reading. My angels, what do you have for my Aries gang? Blessing, guidance, advice, or a message for my Aries gang for this reading? Blessing. Oh yeah, see, Aries in the tarot, you guys are the Fool card is an Aries card, right? New beginnings, brand new opportunities, taking a leap of faith. And see what my angels have given you. Child. So see everything from a fresh new perspective. I think you've been given a new life. Nothing of the old is going to stay, from what I feel. Even if it's with a past person, it'll be a brand new dynamic, because somebody seems to have found their self-worth. They're no longer giving to anyone who's going to take from them, right? Okay, so people can hold on for as long as they want. Let's see what's going on. So King of Wands, Spirit, and the Queen of Cups. King of Wands and the Queen of Cups. Okay, so what's happened, Aries? There was this person who was being selfish in the past, and there was absolute stagnation here. Nothing was really moving. Somebody was trying to control the situation by, you know, only thinking of themselves and not giving to the connection. Even if they were giving something to the connection, Aries, it was really tiny. It was like, okay, you know, little bit and then no more, little bit and no more. And I think that finally got to this Queen of Cups, who was giving 100%. The other partner, who was the loving, caring, nurturing, said, all right, I have a lot of love to give, but then you know what I'm going to do? I'm going to start going out and working with other people, or working on my own self or my own job, and I'm going to take back my power. Somebody went from being the Queen of Cups to becoming the Empress. Basically meaning working on their own happiness, stability, even though I think they wanted it with this person. They really had a lot of love, genuine love, adoration, caring. Everything was there, and I think this person was also very intuitive. This could be you, Aries. Even though all that was there and they really wanted to work with the selfish person, they wanted to combine forces and be with this person, be the Empress, and expected their partner to be that Emperor, that equal match. Somebody didn't give here. King of Pentacles in reverse, right? Somebody really didn't give to the connection, and let's see. King of Pentacles, Spirit. King of Pentacles. King of Pentacles. Yes, this person was a bit obsessed with their own self. They weren't as bad, I would say, as you know, we've been making them out to be in our past readings. This person from the past, they were actually quite a go-getter. This person was maybe very focused on their projects, their work, their maybe getting a lot of attention. Could be a good-looking person. So they were very confident of who they were in society, in work, in life. And I don't think this person was very ready to settle down. They didn't offer that stability or, you know, position to this Queen of Cups, and that's the reason this Empress dropped them. I don't want you anymore. If you're not going to give to me, I'm dropping you. And I think since this open conversation has happened between the two of you, Aries, with the Ace of Swords, this is like clarity. This could have been a face-to-face communication where you guys, or at least one person, said, hey, listen, I don't want you anymore, I'm not talking to you. Or this could be energetic, but somebody got that clarity and they went totally silent after that and started the process of healing their own heart. Not only healing their own heart, but becoming the best version of themselves for themselves. Ace of Swords, Spirit. Ace of Swords. Ace of Swords. Yes, not only did they get clear about the past person, but they also realized that, hey, you know, I can have a brand new start. I have many, many, many options now in front of me. I can choose to plant this big Ace of Pentacles wherever I wish. I'm not subject to this past person anymore. I'm the Empress now, right? So somebody came into this realization that they weren't stuck. They don't have to be stuck in the past with somebody who's never going to. I mean, the only thing they were offering was this little pentacle, right? I mean, Aries doesn't want that. Aries has their own big pentacle, and they felt, I have an option now. I can go wherever I want. I'm clear about, you know, the fact that I will not be juggled anymore. I'm not going to be one of the options. I know my worth. I am the Ace of Pentacles. So the High Priestess, Spirit. High Priestess. High Priestess. Oops, too many cards. What's this High Priestess, Spirit? yeah, absolutely. Aries, once this secret, all the secrets came out of this person who was juggling or who was troubling or who was not committing, once all these secrets came out, I think the person who was giving of their love, they started this brand new chapter of forward movement, of saying, hey, I have a lot of options. See, this is Seven of Cups and the Seven of Wands here, right? Eight of Wands, sorry, I made a mistake. So Eight of Wands is communication, fast forward movement, moving ahead, turning your back to the past and seeing, hey, let me see what else is out there. I have so much to look forward to. I have so many other cups to kind of figure out or choose from. So I think that's the reason of the silence. And once this happened, the healing process began of the Three of Swords. Three of Swords in reverse, Spirit. Yes, Aries, here you are. For a second I was thinking, I said, I hope I'm reading this correct. And then guess what showed up? The Emperor, which is again your card, Aries. You took back control, you took back charge of your life. And not only that, because you started taking care of yourself and your own self-worth, here you are coming out as the Queen of Pentacles. This is somebody who is highly respected, who is looked at as a very nurturing, self-sufficient provider, a person who anybody would want in their life, right? So here you are sitting on your throne as the Emperor, very stable, very kind, caring, loving. Earlier, maybe you were coming across only as a Queen of Cups, right? The person who was gentle, sweet, loving, giving. And now you have combined these two energies of the Emperor and the Queen of Pentacles. Now this is like really taking back control of your life and being seen and valued of that as well. But there is somebody here who's they're not happy, very restless. Four of Swords, Spirit. Oh yes, this person is now becoming more and more restless, Aries, because whoever this high priestess is, could be you, right? Who's kind of taken back their control and power. Since you started holding back from them, this person has become very restless. I think they got used to taking. Why am I not getting any more? Why is Aries holding back all the time? And they're also very scared that maybe you're upset and angry with them. They feel that luck is on your side now. You're moving on and you don't give an F about them anymore. You are the Queen of Wands now in reverse. Angry, upset with them and moving on with your own life. And holding back from them, which is making them very, very restless and unhappy. Okay, till here, I understand. I would have said, okay, out with the old, in with the new. But the last card here is the Death in reverse, which means this person is still holding on. Death in reverse, Spirit. Death in reverse. Death in reverse. This person can hold on for as long as they want, Aries. Yes, they don't want to let go. They are holding on to that last shred, maybe energetically trying to block you from kind of moving on here. They don't want to see you with anyone else. They are trying very hard to stop you from maybe partnering up with somebody else or moving on in life. But that's only because they're not very happy. They're not happy with, by the way, you know, earlier this person could have been chuffed, could have been happy, but now they have problems in their life, so they are not happy. They really, really wish that they could find some way to end this fight. They want to end this fight, this conflict that you guys are both in. They are really wishing and hoping to leave all this trouble, and if you guys can kind of make up and find some kind of peace and harmony with each other. The only problem is here, Aries, that they are, I think, going through a very difficult time. They're going through the dark night of the soul, right? This card has also come in twice here. See, Ten of Swords and the Ten of Swords. This person is at the lowest low. Why? Because they feel that you don't trust them anymore. They don't know what to say, how to come forward. They feel that you have lost your trust, you are angry, you're upset, you're bitter, you're never going to forgive them, and they're feeling defeated. But maybe energetically, I know that's really difficult to understand. And that's why most Aries are finding it difficult, I think, to find new love at the moment. This person is kind of still trying to block. Right? And I know a lot of comments are going to come to say, hey, how do we kind of get unblocked? Just continue being what you're being, right? Continue focusing on yourself. The more involved you get elsewhere, the lesser the energy can affect you. That's all I can say. I mean, I don't believe in any spells. I don't believe in any magic. I just feel, be this, be the empress, be the emperor. You are coming, showing across as that. And focus on yourself, on your own stability. Like, these are beautiful cards of somebody taking back their power. The faster you're going to kind of, you know, focus and take care of yourself, the faster you can move on in life. But this person is, why are they doing this? Like, can I ask this question? Even though this is a love bite, I'm curious to know. So, spirit, why is this person not allowing Aries to move on? Aries, this person has chosen you. This is a card of the lovers, right? And when it's in reverse, it means somebody has made a choice. So, what's this choice? What's this choice, spirit? What have they chosen? What do they want? Why are they blocking my Aries? One more. Yes, they don't want this chapter to end. One more. All three major arcanas here, Aries. One more. Oh, they want to come out of this place of feeling. They don't want to be spending the rest of their life in regret and sorrow. They know what they've done. They don't want to be, you know, crying over spilt milk. They want to get out of this zone. They know their right choice. They know who they should have chosen. They feel they made a very poor judgment in the past, Aries, and they are really, really suffering for it. They have they've been stuck. They've been thinking about it, seeing it from all different sides, hanging upside down by a tree, seeing it from every angle possible. And what this person has realized now, no, I can't let my Aries go. I don't want to shut this chapter down with them. I want to be what they've been wanting all along. I want to be this King of Pentacles upright, the one they weren't in the past. Now they want to be this and prove to their partner to say, hey, you know what I mean. So yes, we'll get in more in depth on Monday now to see, we'll take you versus them and see what's happening, or maybe if some new love is trying to come in, let's see. So till then, love and light, take care, namaste.